A warm welcome to those who have this chance or opportunity to watch from this video. I know you are watching, you are not watching it accidentally, but it's for a purpose. My name is Michael Chieta from Zambia, and in Zambia it's right now in the morning, so I'll say good morning, but I know others are in different countries, different times. So yeah, in Zambia, but it's good morning, so just accept my greetings. I'll say good morning. And in Zambia language, we say good morning. Remember that Mwashibukeni. That's a Bemba language of greeting someone. Good morning. Mwashibukeni. On today's lesson, we are going to learn about five things that Paul listed out to Timothy that he should be an example of believers. So definitely the book that we are going to read from is 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 4. The Bible reading is taken from the book of 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 12. The Bible reads, "Let no one despise you for your youth, but set the believers an example in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity." But for today's lesson, we are only going to zero in or concentrate or target the first example which Paul said in speech. And the rest of these examples, very soon the videos will come out to complete the whole lesson. So, but for today we are going to zero in speech, the example in speech. A believer should be an example in speech. If we look in one of the synoptic books, which is the book of Luke chapter 6 verse 45, Jesus was saying that out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So here we can learn one or two things that Jesus was trying to teach. He was trying to say that, or he was teaching that, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Meaning, a person can be expressed his thinking or what is inside of his heart through words. He can express himself, or he can explain or exhibit what he is thinking inside his or her heart through the words that are coming out of his or her mouth. The other way a person can express himself is through action, which definitely Paul talks about it, the conduct or the behavior. But on today's lesson, just like I said here earlier on, we are going to zero in to be an example as a believer in speech. We know that we use words to communicate to each other. We can use words to build one another. We can use words to preach the gospel. Definitely, of course, even the action can be used to preach the gospel, or the conduct that we are representing. So, we can use words to build something, or we can use words to destroy something, or we can use words to build someone or to destroy someone. So, on today's lesson, just like I said here earlier on, we are learning about to be an example in speech. To be honest with you, some of us in church, we have chased people because of our words that we utter, because of our speech, hate speech or hatred that we utter towards other people, or because of the words that we launch to them. We have chased a lot of people. We have destroyed marriages because of our speech. We have destroyed the faith of someone because of our speech. But Paul is saying, as a believer, be an example in speech. As a believer, we are not supposed to our hearts. How many people have we chased away from Christ because of our words that we speak from our mouth? How many families have we divided? How many family members have I scattered because of my mouth or because of my speech? Let's read James chapter 1, verse 19 to 26. I think we'll just read verse 19. James chapter 1, verse 19. My dear brothers and sisters, take note of this. Everyone should be quick to listen and slow to speak and slow to become angry. Here in the book of James, there are two things that I want to talk about. The author has said that as believers, we should be quick to listen and slow to speak. But to some of us, it's opposite. We are very quick to speak and slow to listen or to understand. No wonder we find ourselves in problems. No wonder we find ourselves in unnecessary debates. Because we are very fast to speak and slow to listen. But as a believer, just like Paul said, we should be an example in speech. Before we speak, we should process what we are going to speak. Is this what I'm going to speak going to build my friend or my family or the congregation or my fellow believer? Or is it going to destroy him? Is it going to contribute something to his life positively or negatively? That's what Paul was trying to teach. So as a believer, my friend, I would like to advise you that we should always calculate our words that are coming out from the mouth. What I mean to calculate our words that are coming out from the mouth, we should process them to check them. Are they going to build someone or are they going to destroy someone? We should be very, very careful on the words that we utter, on the words that we speak towards our friend, or on the speech that we deliver. I think the second verse from the last is taken from the book of Proverbs, that is in OT, Old Testament. Proverbs chapter 21, verse 23. Those who guide their mouths and their tongues keep themselves from calamity. I repeat, Proverbs chapter 21, verse 23. Those who guide their mouths and their tongues keep themselves from calamity. Yeah, I'm not going to waste much time, but I would like to make you remember the story of Balaam, that's in the book of Numbers. The story of Balaam. Balaam was hired to go and curse the Israelites. Mind you, that nation was blessed by God. He tried by all means to curse them. But what God has blessed, no man can curse. By all means to curse the Israelites, but he failed. He tried by all means, but he failed. Even some of us, we are very, very, very active. Our mouth is very, very active to curse others. We may end up cursing those who are blessed by God. And that will bring calamity on us. Look at the end of this Balaam. His end was not good. He used other formula of cursing them. But he never knew that he was just destroying himself. So, my dear brothers and brethren, we should be very, very careful how we are using our speech. We may end up in calamities because of not knowing how to control our mouth and how to control our tongue. Remember, the Bible is saying that the power of death and life lies in your tongue, in your mouth. So we choose very, very wisely. The last verse is taken from the book of Titus chapter 3 verse 2. Titus chapter 3 verse 2. Allow me to explain this. In the pretext of Titus chapter 3 verse 2, the verses above there, they talk about the good works. And in the pretext there, it talks about our characteristics that we experience before all our nature that was coming out from us, or the works of the flesh that we had before we received the Lord Jesus Christ as our personal Savior. Now let's read the context. Titus chapter 3 verse 2. To speak evil of no one, to avoid quarreling, be gentle, to show effect, courteous ways, oh people. Here, I just want to outline one or two things. I'm going to talk about quarreling and speaking evil. Some of us, we indulge ourselves in debate and end up in quarreling because we always use evil ways. We always use words that hate someone. As a believer, it is not good to hate someone intentionally. It is not right to hate someone intentionally. Sometimes our words, we calculate them just to speak something that will hurt our fellow believers. But don't we know that we are chasing other people who are observing, who are studying, who are carefully examining our speech that is coming out of our mouth? Don't we know that we are driving them away from Christ? We blaspheme the word of God or the name of God because of our speech. In conclusion, I'll just say, you should know that words that comes out from our mouth can unite the church members or our families at home, and can also divide our church members or our families at home. Secondly, as a believer, you should watch out how you are talking to someone, because you may end up preaching the bad gospel. You may end up preaching or misrepresenting Jesus Christ because of your ways. And finally, I'll say, as an evangelist or a teacher, you should be very, very careful on the words that you are using or how you are using your mouth. Never ever use your mouth to preach false gospel or false doctrine because you need something. No. Never ever misuse the word of God. Because at the end of the day, we will be judged according to our own deeds that we are doing right now. For now, I'll say, actually, we are going to end. The next video will cut a believer as an example in conduct. I hope you follow and learn something from the next video, just like today. I hope you have learned one or two things. For now, I'll say bye-bye. May God bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.